Hi. Today, we are talking about a very interesting topic, that is importance of chemistry in daily life. Chemistry is actually everywhere. Have a look at yourself. Look at the clothes that you wear. It involves chemistry. The dyes on your clothes, the synthetic fibers through which they are made, it involves chemistry. Have a look around your room. Everywhere you will see paint. That paint and color is also chemistry. Then have a look at the construction of the building in which you are sitting. The concrete, the cement, and other metals that involved in the construction also involves chemistry. A lot of chemicals are there in your body. A lot of mechanisms involve chemical reaction. Then look at the plants and look at the environment, the air. It also involves chemistry. Have a look at your parts. The parts that are made up of plastic or glass, they also involve chemistry. Then have a look at the paper or your book. Manufacturing of paper also involves chemistry. In short, everything around us involves chemistry. Cosmetics, cloths, paints, cleaners, food, fire, medicines, drugs, and the pesticides also. So these all are the different kind of fields in which chemistry plays an important role. Literally, chemistry is everywhere around us. Here we have some reasons that make us understand why we need to study chemistry. Chemistry makes life's little mysteries a little less mysterious. It means chemistry helps you to understand the world around you. Studying chemistry develops analytical skills that helps you to use different tools and to work with them. Chemistry opens up career options. The careers in chemistry are so vast. Depends on your interest. You can be a scientist, you can be a chemist, you can be a lab attendant, you can be a researcher, you can be a manufacturer, you can work in different industries, textile industry, cement industry, paper industry, and much more. And you can be a forensic expert also, you can be a teacher also, you can work in law also. You have a lot of careers to do if you are a chemist. Then comes chemistry helps you to understand the world around you. Why do leaves change color in the fall? Why are plants green? How is cheese made? These all are the questions that can be answered by applying chemistry. Chemistry is a central science. Actually, the best reason to study chemistry is because it is the central science. Chemical principles touch on biology, physics, geology, astronomy, medicine, engineering, mathematics, and other disciplines also. Even if you never study science, having a basic understanding of chemistry helps with everyday life. This is because chemistry is the study of chemicals and the way they react with each other. So it means chemistry is the central science. Chemistry teaches us useful skills that help us to live. A command of chemistry can help keep you safe. You will know which household chemicals are dangerous to keep together or mix and which can be used safely. Chemistry is fun also. There are lots of interesting chemistry projects you can do using common everyday materials. Chemistry projects don't just go boom. They can glow in the dark, change colors, produces bubbles, and change states also. So these all are the reasons, and many more are there due to which you can study chemistry. And these reasons can motivate you to study chemistry, to have a better idea about yourself and the world around you. No doubt, chemistry is very important and chemistry is involved in every field of life. Literally in every field of life. Now have a look at this, why I am saying so. Food. Understanding chemistry helps decipher food labels, understanding vitamins, minerals, proteins, fats, carbohydrates is the same as understanding the chemistry. These all involve chemistry. and then cooking also. When we cook food, it involves chemistry. Then comes agriculture. No doubt, chemistry is involved in agriculture also, whether crops are grown for food or as a source of other products, such as ethanol. Their success depends on chemistry. This includes soil pH. What is the pH of soil? Is it better to grow our certain desired crops? Then comes fertilizers. Fertilizers are just a magic for the plants. They grow plants, they nourish them, they give us our desired products, and they give us a great yield of crops also. So fertilizers also involves chemistry. And then to check the quality of the plants, to check the quality of the crops, to check whether they are ripened or not, these all involve chemistry. Then comes pest control. Pesticides, herbicides, fungicides, and algicides all are chemicals. The pests that are there in our homes, the pests that are there on the crops, we can get rid from all of them with the help of chemistry. Knowing how to use them correctly and understanding the risk they pose is a matter of chemistry. In this way, chemistry is very, very important in pest control also. Once we are done with controlling the pest on our crops, they will give us a great yield. Then comes construction. Now, have a look at the building in which you are sitting. It involves chemistry. Concrete, metals, steel, iron, all involves chemistry. Materials used in construction are chemicals. A lot of science goes into the composition of steel or concrete, from roof membranes that reflect light and keep roofs cool, to sealants and caulks used to keep basements dry. These all involve chemistry. Then comes cleaners, the cleaners that we use to clean our home. Soap, detergents, and bleach, all are chemicals. Choosing the best product and knowing which one shouldn't be mixed is a matter of chemistry. Colors come from light, physics, but also pigments and dyes. These pigments and dyes are chemistry. The colors on your curtains, the colors on your carpets, the colors on your dresses, the colors on different stuff, they all come from chemistry. Energy also include chemistry. Fuels and energy production rely on chemistry. This is not only include fossil fuels and batteries. Designing solar cells and biofuels is also a matter of chemistry. So you can see, no field is there which didn't involve chemistry. So in short, chemistry is everywhere. Then comes drugs. Drugs and supplements are also chemicals. From treatment of cancer to the vaccination of COVID-19 and the simple painkillers that we take to get rid of any pain, headache, these all involve chemistry. The manufacturing of these drugs, the formulas, chemistry gives us answer of the questions, what happened with the drug when it goes in our body, how it digests, how it works for different diseases, and moreover, what are the side effects of all these drugs. Metals and alloys are chemicals. Chemistry explored their purification from ores, process them, and help them to stop from corrosion. Here, all the metals, from iron to gold, chemists extract them and then purify them. Textile. In textile industry, chemistry is very important. Textile chemistry include the production and processing of natural fibers like cotton, silk, wool, and moreover, synthetics also, like nylon, polyester. All fibers involve chemistry. So it means the cloths we are wearing, these also involves chemistry. The colors on them, these also involve chemistry. Plastics and other polymers are chemicals. Chemistry studies how these compounds are made and then recycled. No doubt, plastics are not degradable. But now Chemists are working on it, and they are making such plastics who are biodegradable. So these plastics are made up of polymers that involves chemistry. Remediation. Chemistry plays a significant role not just in causing pollution, but also in cleaning it up. Cosmetics. Cosmetics are chemicals that are used to affect our appearance. The key ingredients present in most cosmetics include water, emulsifiers, preservatives, thickeners, moisturizers, color, and fragrances. And these involve chemistry. So the manufacturing of all the cosmetic products, from lipstick to mascara, everything involves chemistry. Paper. The paper and pulp industry involves the chemistry of compounds in wood, cellulose, that is the major part of paper, lignin. Then there are different types of chemicals that are used to make pulp. Even the manufacturing of tissue paper also involves chemistry. Health. Your genetics depend on DNA, which is a chemical. Your health depends on biochemical reactions within the body, the enzymes that speed up the reactions in your body. Medical tests use chemical to assess your wellness. So by concluding, chemistry is everywhere around you. Your clothes, the dyes, the air, the water you drink, the medicines you take, the building in which you live, the paper on which you write, the cosmetics you use, the soap, washing powders, shampoo, pesticides in agriculture, chemistry is everywhere. So I think this is enough motivation for you to study or to understand or to explore chemistry. So explore chemistry. It will never disappoint you. This is enough for our today's lesson. If you like the video, press the like button, comment, subscribe, and follow this channel for more informative videos. Thank you.